Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to create an awesome lower third for free in HitFilm Express. So we're going to start with productioncrate.com. If you do not have an account with productioncrate.com, please do me a favor. In the description of this video, there is an affiliate link to productioncrate.com. Click on that link and then create yourself a free account with them so that you can download these free assets. And this will really help my channel also. So after you have created your free account and you go to productioncrate.com, in the search bar, you want to type in lower thirds and you'll click on the very first thing that you see. Now, if you start scrolling down this, you will see that you have a bunch of these different lower thirds. These ones with the stars are the pro versions. In other words, you have to have a pro account with them. And if you have a pro account, great, then you can use these also. But if you do not have a pro account, you just have the free account, then you have to scroll down to the bottom where all of a sudden you'll start finding these lower thirds that have no star, like this one here and this one here and so on and so forth, okay? Then what you do is you start looking at these and you decide which one you want. So say, for example, this Action Sports lower third. See how it kind of slid on and then it just sort of disappears, right? This Universal lower third slides on and then hangs out and then slides off. So some of these will actually slide on and then slide off, and some of them will just disappear. Okay, this one, the corporate lower third here, for example, it slides on and slides off. So I'm gonna use this Action Sports lower third just for this tutorial and just for this example. It slides on and then disappears, but we can make it slide off, and I'll show you how in a second. So now here I am in HitFilm Express. This is the free version of HitFilm Express with no add-ons. I have brought into my media bin the footage crate action sport lower third.mov file, as well as a picture of Muhammad Ali, the greatest. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put Muhammad Ali here on the editor timeline. Actually, you can see it's a little bit small. So I'm just going to right click and say transform fit to the frame width, so that there's this picture of him here, okay? Now, above that, I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to say insert a track, and I'm just going to right-click, rename that track, lower third, okay? And that's where the lower third will end up going, so that way we can come to and from this editor timeline, so you get an idea of how that lower third's going to end up looking, all right? I'm going to new composite shot. And I'm just going to call this composite shot Action Sports lower third. And I like my lower thirds to be pretty quick, like 5 seconds or less. So I'm going to make this a 5 second lower third, clicking OK. All right. Now I'm going to bring in the Action Sports lower third. Whoops. I'm going to bring in the footage crate Action Sports lower third. And you'll see that it slides on. And then after 5 seconds, it's still on, okay? So let's go ahead and do a little bit of cleanup work. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to slide forward until it actually appears on the screen. There's where it appears on the screen in the 14th frame. I'm going to back up one frame, and then I'm just going to trim that and bring it forward because I want it to start on the first frame like this, or, you know, on the first frame, there's nothing. On the second frame, it's already there. So if I come back out to the sports or to the editor timeline and I bring in my Action Sports thing, then you'll see it already is transparent. So it's not like I have to add any keying to make it transparent. It is an MOV file. So it looks pretty good, right? There it is. All right. Now here's going to be the deal. Halfway through, and if it is one of those lower thirds that sort of shuts itself off, you could just make it, you know, that way. But this isn't going to work. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to slice that, and then I'm going to delete that. Okay, so this is the first half of the lower third, the first 2.5 seconds, okay? Now, what I want to do is I want to take this exact same 2.5 seconds, and I want to reverse it and have it end up over here. And here's how you're going to do this. You're going to right-click on this and duplicate that, and then add a new grade layer. Place the grade layer between those two media clips, and then to that grade layer, you want to add a time reverse effect to the grade layer itself. And that's it. You don't want to move this around. You don't want to whatever. This grade layer will flip this over to the other side. And so now the entire thing will slide out. It has its little shinies and stuff. And then, and it slides off. And if we go back out to the editor timeline, you can see it looks exactly the way that we want it to look. And for 5 seconds, it's out. Okay, so now let's go ahead and add in the title itself. So we go back into the composite shot. And what I will do is just simply add a new text layer. And I'm just going to type in Muhammad Ali, enter, and he is or was the greatest. Okay, so there it is. Now, if I click on the selection tool, I can move this thing down here and maybe over a little bit. As it turns out, it happens to be just about the right size. But I could change that and everything. I'm going to go into the text file itself, and I think I'm just going to change the color of this to match this red down here so that it looks like it fits here in the scene, and maybe make it a little bit of an adjustment here like that. Okay, so now if I go back out to scale to fit, pretty much that's it. So now if we come back out to the editor, you can see that looks really sweet, doesn't it? And so now, zoom, right, there it is. There is a problem, though, and that is that, you know, even though the actual lower third graphic is wiped off, the lettering is still there, right? And it's there in the front, too. So we don't want that. So what we're going to do is you could just mask that with the timing of that, and that would certainly work. But there's an easier way to do that. What we're going to do is I'm just going to add yet another grade layer, but I will put it above the graphic items, but below the text. And then new text under the effects, I will search for the set matte effect. And I'm just going to use the graphic as a matte to cut out the text when that matte is not there. So if I open this up and I say source layer, that new grade layer, which of course flattens everything and basically takes into account everything, now you can see that that is working, except that it's messed up everything underneath there also, but that's okay. All we have to do is open this up, and I'm just going to invert the matte and then set the blend mode to subtract. And when I do that, now guess what? It will work exactly the way that we want it to. Looks very nice and very clean. And when we come back out to the editor timeline, you can see there is your brand new lower third created, ready to be used. It can be placed above any video in the editor timeline and it will work perfectly. Now, if I wanted to move it around a little bit, I could move it around in here, or I could move it around on the editor timeline. If you wanted to move it around in here, what you would do is you'd create a point, and then you essentially would parent everything to that point. And then you could move that point and it will move everything. So for example, maybe I want that to be in the lower left-hand corner or something like that. Okay. After I've done that, of course, I would want to save this in case I ever wanted to use it again. So I would come over to the media bin. I would right-click on that and say save as, and just save it as a composite shot. Then if you ever need it, you can just come in and say import a composite shot, go find it wherever you saved it, make a folder on your computer that says lower thirds, and you can use that. What I would do is go to Production Crate, get all of those free lower thirds, and then just create each one. You could spend probably a half an hour and create a dozen of those, or maybe half a dozen of those, and you'd have a bunch to choose from, and you have your own personal collection of lower thirds. So if you have any questions about how to do this, do me a favor and put them in the comments below. If you like this kind of a thing, like the video, subscribe, share it with your friends, and I really appreciate you watching. Okay. And here we go. Ready? In 3, 2, 1. Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to create an awesome... Again, in 3, 2, 1.